What's up, everybody? Big Herc 916, and you tune into another edition of my vlog. Hit the subscribe button, man. Go ahead and support the channel, share it with your friends, and pass along the word. You know, I'm all about the positivity and the motivation, and I try to keep you guys laced up and hopefully making better choices than what I did in my life. And today I want to talk about rap music and the gang culture and what it's become today. I mean, you know, rap music and violence and things of that nature, it's nothing new. I mean, you know, I used to listen to gangster rap as a kid and my mom didn't like it. And, you know, I'd be bumping some old schooly D or some old school Ice T or some King T, you know. Those are some of the ones I could think off the top of my head, you know, that I used to listen to. And, you know, they were considered pretty hard for back in the day. You know, these are predecessors to like the Ghetto Boys and some of the other legendary gangster rap artists, you know, N.W.A., you know, to name a few. But, you know, the thing about music in the black culture is that in order to be authentic, a lot of times, you know, you got to live the life. You can't be talking about things you don't have. You can't talk about things you haven't done. You know, you got to somehow have some connection to that lifestyle in order to sell, you know, to sell the record. You know, you listen to country music, you know, they're not, you know, out there talking about, you know, shooting a neighbor or, you know, beating up this guy over here at a club. You know, they just, you know, they talk about stories and live their life. You know, they might drink a little bit or do whatever they do, but and party, but they're not actually committing the acts or promoting country gangs or whatever the case may be. So they don't have that risk involved. It doesn't affect their kids or their audience like, you know, the hip-hop culture does. You know, the hip-hop culture, man, is a whole nother animal. It's under a lot more scrutiny. And, you know, just look at the whole hip-hop police thing, you know. Going back to, you know, Biggie and Tupac, you know, East Coast, West Coast, you know, the feds investigating, you know, Jay Prince and Irv Gotti, you know, a lot of these guys, you know, who have been under fire for their music and how they have used those music proceeds, you know, to do certain things. And, you know, people just gotta be conscious, man, that be careful of what you say, be careful of what you do and what you promote, man. You know, you don't wanna bring that unwanted scrutiny or attention to yourself and be caught up in a situation. I mean, it's all cool when you're traveling, making money, you know, and nowadays, you know, there's so many cameras, so everybody's filming everything. You're filming all your fights, you're filming all your deals, your underground transactions. I mean, you're putting everything out there, right up into the iCloud, so they can download it, you know, go through and build your case. And it happened with Tekashi69, you know. You don't know if that bodyguard is a CI. You don't know if you're, you know, that guy who says he's a manager's assistant is a CI. You don't know anything about these people, and you have them in your circle, and you're talking, you know, you're talking openly about different things. So you got to be more conscious, man. You got to realize that the hip-hop community is a different animal. It's not like country music. It's not like pop. You know, it's a totally different community, and people are watching. And when you're out there and you're, you know, promoting sliding on people and doing violent things and, you know, showing gang activity, they have laws for that shit, you know. They have things that they'll put together and throw at you, man. And a lot of times you see these young rappers and they're, you know, doing their thing. And, you know, they're in the hood still and they're flossing and, you know, they you know, it makes the eyes up above look and say, hey man, what is this guy really doing? Is he making the money off of rap, or is he moving drugs, or is he involved in guns, or whatever the case may be? You know, look at Rollo, you know what I mean? It was like Nino Brown and his crew, you know what I mean? They took him down. They were looking at them for, you know, basically a conspiracy to move drugs, you know, ARAB, man. I mean, you talk about certain things and they look back and see that, hey man, this guy, man, who is this guy? You know, and when you put it out there, you just gotta know that it is being looked at, you know? When people ask you certain questions or try to get you to say certain things, man, you ain't gotta answer them. You ain't gotta put yourself out there and let this dude put you in a twist, because you don't know who is behind him putting together those questions. Oh, DJ Vlad, man, you know, people was like, hey man, this guy said the dude got arrested right after his interview, and you know, DJ Vlad set him up. Well, DJ Vlad, we don't know who put together his questions, and you don't know in what capacity he's operating at. I'm not making any accusations. I'm just saying you gotta be careful. And like I said, a lot of times these cases, you know, don't throw all kind of things in there, you know, and it's not just throwing them in there. They've got the evidence to back them up. I know people who have got caught up in conspiracies, man. And I know people who were actually let out on bail for certain cases so that they could build a federal case. So the state case, they actually will let them out on a state case so that they can build a federal case. And, you know, CI set up cameras, they have certain places they'll take you and you'll talk, and hey man, it'll just be a matter of time. And usually it's 6 months minimum, you know what I mean, that they'll be doing business in multiple transactions, because multiple transactions under the federal statutes create a certain amount of time, and it creates a mandatory minimum. So these are things you guys out there have no clue about. You're smoking way too much weed, so you're not hip. Maybe doing too many Xanax or Percocets, but you guys are just running your mouth, but you're not really paying attention. You get money, you get a lawyer, go get you a Black's Law dictionary. You know, it all ties in, man. You can't be knee deep in all this thug activity and not know the ramifications on the other side. And people make a joke of it, Charlemagne the God. Oh, suck his if he beats his case. Who says that? What wacko says that? Unless you like penis. Charlemagne, why would you say that? It's like these dudes, you know, they make a joke of it, but they have these people on their show so they can get all these fucking views. But then you say if he beats it, you want to suck his penis. Dude, come on, man. This, I mean, and these dudes, people are looking up to him, but he wants to suck another man's penis? Why didn't you say, hey man, I'll take you out to dinner, man, you know, hook you up with some females, not suck your penis? Come on, man. So hip-hop community, man, wake up, man. Be smarter, you know your surroundings, know who you're dealing with. You don't just let somebody in because they come and they say they've been here and done this and that. You don't know who those people are. A lot of these people are agents. They're there to bring you down, to get you caught up. You know, you see it with the women all the time. Bring a girl in there, say she's, you know, of age, she's underage, you know, next thing you know, you got a rape charge, or she said that you held her against her will. All type of shit, man. You guys are getting your wig split from every direction. You know, whether it's in the bedroom trying to have some pleasure, or out running around being a thug. You're getting your wig split, man. You gotta wake up, man. You gotta be smarter. You know, you guys take a lot of time to read a lot of things in a dictionary. Go get the Black's Law dictionary, read up on that. And, you know, watch what you say. Don't, you know, stop incriminating yourself doing stupid stuff and putting your business out there. And it's not even just the feds you gotta worry about, man, or the local police. It's also the local homies that are seeing you on Instagram counting money and, you know, running around at the clubs. They'll go back and rob you. Oh yeah, he's on Instagram, he's at the club. Go back to his house, rob him. You know, it don't matter who's in the house, tie him up, rob him. You know what I mean? These girls, you go to bed with them, you know, they lay you out, get you to bust a couple nuts, unlock the fucking door, get robbed. She put you right to sleep. Yeah, they look innocent. Oh yeah, man, I had a threesome. They put your ass right to sleep, unlock the door, masked men come in, they get a few slaps, you get the beat down. Yeah, it's all inside jobs, man. You can't be that stupid to think that, you know, it's not going down. Oh no, she really likes me. She's into me. No, it don't work like that. Wake up, y'all. Big Herc 916, I'm trying to put you up on game so that you guys can stop getting your wig split.